What's up guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel, and today I'll tell you how can we make rainbow loom. So I'm going to tell you how to make this. I'm not going to tell you how to make the regular fishtail. It's like it's the French fishtail. As you can see, this is yellow and red. This is the combination of blue. I have the shiny blue and the normal one, and I've attached this charm with it. And this is purple and yellow. So let's get started. So first of all, you will need this 2-peg stand, and then you will need this hook. So you can take any hook. Okay guys, so this time I'll be using pink and white. So let's get started. Okay, so first of all, you will take your 2-peg stand and your hook. So firstly, I'll put this white rubber band, the normal crisscross type I'll put, and over it I'll put the pink one, and then again the white one. So you have white, pink, white, like the normal fishtail. When you do it, it's the same. Then you do the normal fishtail style. You'll just take the white one and go up, put it above. And then you will take the pink one. So now there is a difference. What you will do is that you will pick up the white one, the middle one, and you will put it below the pink one. And then you will take the pink one, normal, which was down, and you will pull it up. So what you have to do is that you need to keep doing this. So you need to follow the left-right pattern. Like firstly you will do left, then right, then left. Then I'll take the pink one, the middle pink one, and I'll put it below the white one. So now I have done on the right side, and then I'll regularly put the white one above. And then just push it a little. Then I'll again take my pink one, and this time I'll do the left one. So I'll put the white below the pink and then pull the pink above. So you need to continue following this pattern. Now on the left side again, sorry, the right one, and then above. Yeah. So make sure you just need to pull down from only one side, like you don't need to do it from both the sides. Okay, so like here also I've taken pink and I have put it below white from only one side, that is the right side, and then I'll take the white one and I'll put it above. So you need to continue following this pattern. Okay, so now we'll just continue doing this. So I'll just fast forward the video and then just tell you what to do in the end. Okay, so now we'll end it. So to end, I'll take my white rubber band again and I'll do the normal regular thing which I was doing. And then I'll take the white one and I'll again do what I was doing. So just put it above, and then finally I'll take out my white rubber band. So now here you can see that there is this pattern difference. So what we'll do is that we'll take out the extra rubber bands so that we can after that just join it together. So now you can see you have this pattern, and you can just take all these rubber bands and hook it together. So now I'll just take my hook and I'll just put these rubber bands together. I'll just stretch it like this. I'll take all those rubber bands and stretch it, and then I'll put the hook. Yeah, like this. I'll just put the hook, and then I'll do the same from the other side. I'll take this rubber band, I'll stretch it, and then I'll put this hook. So yeah, now you're ready with your bracelet. And I hope you like this. I really like this pattern, the color combination. So I've also done this. So in this I've put a charm. So what I've done is that the charm had that hole, and I've just put a rubber band inside that hole, and then I just hooked it from one end, and then I took the bracelet and I took a rubber band of the bracelet and I hooked it from the other side of the hook. So it comes together like this. Okay guys, so this was the end of this video, and I hope you like it, and I just hope that you make it. And if you like this video, do give it a thumbs up and do subscribe to my channel if you have not. Thanks for watching.